Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. This is a highly requested juice recipe video. This recipe is geared toward female health, but if you struggle with any type of pain in your body, this is a great recipe, so anyone can drink it. I specifically created this recipe for those who are looking to shrink fibroids, ovarian cysts, people who have polycystic ovarian syndrome, endometriosis. If you drink this juice every day, you will see huge improvements. I'm not claiming cures, but it's certainly possible in my opinion. I'm not a doctor, so you need to check with your healthcare provider. So let's get into making this juice. We're gonna start with 3 small apples. You can use whatever variety of apples you'd like. I think the apple that I have here is a gala apple, but I'm really not sure. Next, you're gonna add 2 lemons, peeled if not organic. I always peel my lemons because I don't like the taste of lemon peels in my juice. But what I do is when I slice the lemon, I try to leave as much of the pith on as I possibly can. But for the most part, I get most of the peel off just because I don't like the taste. Next, you're gonna add a nice chunk of ginger, at least 1 inch of a thumb of ginger. I am working myself up to drinking a lot more ginger. So what you do over time is you just keep adding more and more to your juice until you get used to it. Some people even add less than 1 inch. And if that's what you need to do in order to get used to the ginger, by all means do it. But try to build up to drinking more and more because that is what helps with the pain. Next, you want to add your cucumber. I love using English cucumbers. I don't know why, I just prefer them over regular cucumbers, but in this recipe, either use 2 large English cucumbers or 4 regular sized cucumbers. The next ingredient is fresh mint. I put 1 sprig of mint in this juice. You can feel free to put more. It can be overpowering, so if you don't like the taste of mint, then use less, but use at least 1 sprig, but you can use more if you like mint. Next is our pepper. You can use whatever kind of pepper you'd like, just make sure it's hot. Ideally, a piece of habanero would be perfect, but in this recipe, I used jalapeno because it's easy to get and most people can tolerate it. So start with a little bit, maybe 1/4 of a pepper, and then work your way up from there. In this recipe, I used 1/2, but next time I believe I can handle a whole jalapeno. Next is the spinach. This is the blood builder. You want to use as much spinach as you possibly can in your juices if you struggle from anemia. Perfect from bringing you out of anemia. So for this recipe, I used 2 packed cups of spinach. You can feel free to add more. Next is another pain fighter. This is turmeric. I added 3 small chunks to this juice, but feel free to add as much as you'd like. This is really good if you have pain in your body or if you experience monthly pain or ovulation pain. Turmeric and ginger are the 2 things that I would suggest that you ingest on a daily basis. Start small and build up to more. The next ingredient is celery. I used 2 small bunches of celery hearts for this recipe. Celery is important because it is a great alkalinizer and it also serves as the base for your juice. So when you juice celery, you're going to get lots of juice. Next is a powerful green. This is dandelion greens. This is a great liver cleanser and it is going to build the blood. And if you add this to your drink, it is just going to take it over the top. It's a little bit bitter, so you may have to add a little bit more lemon or apple to this juice if it turns out that your juice is bitter. I used 1/2 of a small bunch of dandelion greens, and I'm a veteran juicer, so it wasn't too bitter for me, but check it, and you may need to add a little bit more apple juice or some lemon to combat some of the bitterness. And last but not least is beet. I leave the skin on the beet. I just wash it really good and I cut the ends off. This is a great blood builder. So if you have anemia, this is going to help you with that problem. But if you look at the way the beet looks, it is circular in shape. It sort of looks like an ovary. Let me just tell you another short story about beets. I was sitting at my desk at work, like probably in 2007, and I was drinking a beet apple juice. And I had a large ovarian cyst at that time, and I was drinking the juice, and I felt something happen in my abdomen. It's almost like my uterus went back into place. Little did I know then, but my ovary, the cyst on my ovary, was actually shrinking and going away. If you struggle with ovarian cysts, drink beet in your juice recipe. Now all you have to do is cut all of those beautiful vegetables up into pieces that will fit into your juicer. This juice will make 64 ounces of juice. It's either good for two people, or you can drink one day and then save the rest for the next day. But I suggest drinking at least 4 cups of juice a day if you're looking for healing in your body. I use the Green Star Elite Juicer. This is the best juicer that I've ever juiced. The juice that comes out of this juicer is just absolutely amazing. This juicer is on the expensive side, so I would, you know, caution you that if you can't afford something like this, then don't. There are other alternatives, but if you're looking to make juicing a habit for your lifetime, this is a good juicer to invest in. I will put a link below for this juicer as well as another juicer that I think that is a good juicer. It's a little bit less expensive. Also, if you haven't already, get your free juicing ebook from me. All you have to do is either text the word juice to 31996 or click the link below, sign up for my email list, and I will send you a link to get the PDF. Okay, y'all, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, take care.